You want to outline your 3D object in Illustrator, and you want it editable. So this one is editable text. Now you have your new text object and you apply a stroke to it, and then you go into the 3D effects and extrude that, and you see this looks completely different. So how do we do this outline? Hi and welcome to this quick tip about Illustrator 3D effects. Let's continue with this object, but I first need to get rid of that stroke. Let's first get this into 3D space. I'm going to use 3D and materials, classic, and extrude and bevel. Just like that. And let's make this a little longer. And also, let's rotate this in space, perhaps like that. And okay. So now in order to get this stroke, we need to have another hierarchical level. To get that, I'm first going to go into the layers panel. Let's go in here and create a new layer. So in order to get this new level, what you can do is of course group this. But we're going to do something different because another hierarchical level could also be the layer itself. So I'm going to first look into this, and you see in here it's a group and everything else is applied to the group. But in here I'm going to use the layer. And in order to be able to do that, what you have to do is target the layer. So click on that circle, which is the target symbol, and then the layer is targeted. In here we have the 3D object, and now I'm going to open the appearance panel like this. So we have the layer up here. And what we now need to do is create that stroke. So just click on add new stroke. There it is. And you see there are a lot of shapes. We're going to deal with that later on. So the next thing we need to do is go up here and to the pathfinders, and then we need to use the merge. And now we still have too many shapes in here. In order to get rid of that, we need to go into the 3D effect itself. So I'm going to target this one just like this, and then we're in here. You see there's a layer, and then we are on the object. In order to get there, you can also double click this. And then in here we have the 3D effect. And then what we need to do is get and edit this one, the surface. And this is set to plastic shading in order to create very soft kind of gradients. We do not need that. And we set that to diffuse shading like that. And then we go into more options, and also in order to get less, we can go to blend steps. This is the number of steps Illustrator creates to get a soft shading. We do not want that, so we can go to 2, like that. Or maybe 4. You can decide that. And then also, of course, edit the lighting. And you can even go into the ambient light and maybe reduce it like that. And you could also add more light to that in order to get a different result here so that this gets more striking. And then you go to OK, and here's your result. You can still either double click it or just use the type tool and just edit the thing. So that's how you create this special kind of stroke on 3D objects. This video covered a lot of different concepts. If you just followed along, you should have arrived at this result. But if you want to dive deeper, then I have some other video recommendations for you. If you want to learn more about the appearance panel and how to navigate in it and create things in it, then you can refer to this video here. If you want to learn how to set up the blend steps in the 3D effect, I would recommend this video. And if you want to learn more about about how to navigate the layers panel and how to address the different levels of hierarchy in it, then I would recommend this video over here.